send Leo in
but
on
that's
Morgana,
leave LeBlanc.
And that leaves LeBlanc for Bobchin.
Okay.
I feel like they've given a lot away to UBC here.
Yeah, so they leave the LeBlanc open. That's the band that fell away to the side that I mentioned at the start. And in it, and she can't do anything after
and
that.
They have, they have a pretty good mixed damage threat because of that, too. I mean, yes, last game they had a lot of damage on the Cho'Gath, but I feel it's a lot harder to make the damage super effective. We'll have to talk about that one later. As Proof comes in, gets the body slam off. That's going to prompt Mini Bestia to flash away, but the exhaust is down on him. Tails is trying to push him back. Mini Bestia's not quite down yet in the hook. Catches Proof of payment. Can't quite make the flay combo,
Oberon,
and it comes
Oberon. He has his own flash. He's going over.
Oh, that's a knock-up on Alan Gale, but he flashes once again. Proof, they really want those buffs reset, but they won't get them.
Lots of trading back and forth.
But two flashes burned on RMU, and they only got the one out of Remy. And there are wards around the area, so RMU would know this is happening. They have a teleport available. DJG, speaking of teleports, taking some damage. Zig actually gets caught up, but Oberon is there. The tables have turned, and the Narbar is about to fill out. Smite's down on him. This is going to be first blood. Who's it going to? It looks like it's going to be Zig.
And he wants that top lane Gnar. He wants to get off the ground. Zig has been a carry for them. Soil first. It's maxed at this point. 5 points in it. Look at this Zig.
Ultimate burn by DJJ. Low action game from kill standpoint. And it's about to change, though. Mini Bestia. 1, 2, 3.
Waiting on heat waves here.
Oberon in the brush.
He's seen, though.
Yeah, he's seen. But he doesn't know he's seen. He waves is trying to play the game out there as Zig jumps over the teleport. Here's Mini Bestia. Oberon taking a whole chunk of damage. He dodges some damage, but he won't get out of that one. The collateral was not what they needed. The rest of it was, and Zig is left for dead. Before his Meganar goes off, he'll get popped by Proof. And so is Mini Bestia.
A huge bait by UBC. They aren't moving around right there just yet. Signature, though.
Oh, Bobchin.
They're looking for...
That's a quick pickoff there. Let's see if RMU can answer back. A Gnar into the wall, but DJJ is still way too tanky.
Bobchin,
he's burning away, but he'll make it back. And the juke. Can Leo pick him off? The Culling doesn't connect. Neither does the binding. And Bobchin, the master of escape. So they get it in time before UBC are there. The answer is yes. It's 2-2, but in comes the Wrecking Ball. DJJ onto Oberon. Tails moves forward. Heat waves. The target. He's not down yet. Finally, Leo will pick him up, and UBC, a big Gnar into the wall, courtesy of Zig. Proof trying to dodge out, but Bobchin is going nuts on the back line. In comes Tails to push him back, and all said and done, it's a 2-for-1. Looking for more, Zig throws the rock as soon as he minis, and he should be able to secure up Proof, but Tails is caught. Oh my goodness, he picks up Bobchin.
That was a really big ultimate from Leo, and he got out alive, and then they just trailed the fight off.
But UBC knows this. There's still a few moments left on the Gnar bar. You have to go for the steal. They've got the double smite available. They go
Leo's
in for it. This is close. It goes down. That's for Oberon. Let's see if they can take this one. Mini Bestia is the target. Proof, however, being chunked down. Oberon taking some serious damage as well. Proof caught in the line. Bobchin should be able to take that Mini Bestia. He does. And Zig, Oberon scattering to the winds. Tails trying to stay safe in this one. If they only lose one, it's not too bad for them. But Heat Waves picks up Oberon. 2-for-none so far. They've got no tower to back to as Tails, exhausted, tries to flash away. But Bobchin picks him up anyways. 3-4-0. And they'll take Leo as well. The shutdown and a double kill for Bobchin. Risky advantage that RMU have been able to get is effectively neutralized. Bobchin's in that brush. There's the Prey Seeker. Siding him out, he looks for Oberon. Backs away. They've got the Scuttlecrab control. Zig's around the side, but that won't be enough right now. And he's locked up on the chains. Ignite as he hops. It won't be enough to get away. Bobchin has some damage on him. The Narbar's coming up, but will it get in time? Yes, it is. But Oberon now is the target, and he's going down. That's Bobchin to pick him off. Meanwhile, in the Dragon Pit, Leo comes in, goes out. But they've lost a man already. Collateral damage, blowback. Leo very low. Proof is going to be picked off. It looks like not quite as Bobchin comes in and absolutely demolishes Tails. And Leo, they go through to get another. And it's Heatwaves picking up Mini Bestia. UBC roll through the jungle and roll through RMU. It's like that once again. 10-1 and 3 on this LeBlanc. It's getting out of hand very quick, unless they can answer back, but they've already lost Mini Bestia, the Monsoon, and the Zhonya's to keep Bobchin alive. They're focusing tunnel vision on, but Heatwave is gonna still get the pickoff. Finally, Bobchin goes down, but at what cost, Irene? They've lost 3 members. Is the Gnar enough to make the difference? I don't think so. Down goes Oberon. Zig is all by himself, and there is no inhibitor in the middle. That's the ace. 42 minutes in, the teleport comes in. They wanna end this right now.
That's going to be game UBC taking it 3-0 over the school that recruits talent from all over North America. South America. They bring
everywhere.
In new talent, and they still get beaten by this squad of ragtag Canadian students.
Big, big win for the University of British Columbia here. The best in the West have proved that they are the best in North America.